Hi friends, welcome to this video. In this video, we'll be talking about Kubernetes or KH Lab 101, building single master cluster. In step zero, create Docker Hub account if you don't have it already. In step one, open Play with Kubernetes, log in with your Docker Hub account. Step two, click on Start. Step three, add a new instance. Step four, click in Terminal and press Enter. Step five, enter the command kubeadm init API server advertise address $hostname-i pod network CIDR 10.5.0.0/16. Use kubeadm to initialize Kubernetes cluster. API server advertise address is to advertise API server address. We will be covering API server and other components in future videos. Pod network CIDR is to provide subnet used for pod network. We'll be covering pod and other components in future videos. This command will pull container images required for Kubernetes cluster and may take some time. You may load images proactively by using kubeadm config images pull. You may also select specific version with option of Kubernetes version. Take note of output similar to below. It'll be required for other nodes to join the cluster. Kubeadm join IP address :6443 token discovery token CA cert hash. In step six, type in kubectl get nodes. Use above command to check nodes in KH cluster. There will be only master node with status not ready. Node is not ready as there's no networking add-on. In step seven, we'll be installing the networking add-on. Kubectl apply-f URL for kubeadm kube router. This command will get YAML file from GitHub, install networking add-on to the cluster. In step eight, let's check the node again. This time you'll see node will be in ready state. In step nine, add new instance. In step 10, you have to use the kube join command, which you have found in step five. This command will join new node to cluster. This command will be different for you, and you'll get this from step five. Step 11, let's check the nodes. You'll see two nodes, one master, second with none role. Second node might be not ready at first. It could take a few minutes to get ready. Step 12, add new instance. Step 13, use the command which you have found in step 5 to join this node to the cluster. Go back to the first node and type in kubectl get nodes. You'll see three nodes, one master, two with the none role. Third node might be not ready at first. It could take a few minutes to get ready. So let's get started. Click on the link to open a new window for Play with Kubernetes. In the dropdown, select Docker. Click on Start. Click on Add New Instance. Copy the command of kubeadm init API server advertised address. Hostname-i is the IP address of this host where we are running this command. This host will be acting as API server, so we're using that as an option here. For pod network CIDR, we are giving 10.5.0.0/16. You have to give one which is specific in your network when you're building a real production cluster. Pulling images required for setting up a Kubernetes cluster. This might take a minute or two, depending on the speed of your internet connection. You can also perform this action beforehand by using kubeadm config images pull, similarly as we discussed in the notes. So if we check the logs, it'll show us that certificate directory folder is etc Kubernetes PKI, and it's generating certificate for different components inside Kubernetes. Now it has created the components for Kubernetes internals. As you can see here, you should now deploy a pod network to the cluster. And this is our next step. As node stated, we have a node with role master and status is not ready. This is because we don't have the CNI or the networking add-on yet. Let's do kubectl apply minus f is for the file. And we're getting file from the GitHub. Now our node is in ready state. Let's add new instance. Go back to the first node. Take this join command. Copy it. Go to the second node. Enter that command. And you'll see similar steps will go in here, but it'll be much faster. Only kubelet is the one which will be running here. We'll be discussing the components in the future videos. Let's go to the master and do kubectl get nodes again. Now we can see we have two nodes and both of them are in ready state. role for first one as master and second one as none. Let's add a new node, end with the same command, kubeadm join IP address colon 6443 token and discovery token CSRT hash. And this node has joined the cluster as well. So if you go to the master node, you'll see all three nodes are there and all of them are ready. You can run these commands only on the master node. So kubectl commands could be run only on the master node. Let's delete the instances. And close the session. Thank you for joining us today. Please like and share this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel for regular updates, and join us on Slack for interactive chat.